Wildfire by Sneaky Bastards is a 2D stealth game where you harness the elements to outwit your superstitious foes. After a mysterious meteorite imbues you with magical abilities, you are labelled a witch and hunted by the evil Archduchess's troops. Armed with nothing but your ingenuity and newfound powers, you must escape and free your fellow villagers. Wildfire's mechanics promote creative thinking to complete levels in a satisfying way. Things like using water to scare enemies into jumping off a ledge, making a bubble to float through the air, throwing down grass to pickpocket enemies, or forcing a chicken to help you fly. Each of these options and many more make the skills feel unique and creates fun moments that break up the slower pace of the stealth-based encounters. The game does not punish you for choosing to play aggressively. Instead, completing levels in a quick and sneaky way will reward you with additional spirit points, which can be used to purchase optional skill upgrades. This approach feels welcoming for players who, like myself, prefer a more guns blazing playstyle, as it encouraged me to use stealth tactics, but still gave me the choice to fight enemies if I wanted to. Playing solo is a viable option, although one of the absolute best parts of Wildfire is the co-op. Laughing at your partner when they jump into a spike pit, or frantically yelling at them to take cover because you were trying to be stealthy, showcases the care that Sneaky Bastards has taken to craft an enjoyable cooperative experience. Simple controls that are constantly on screen and the ability to easily swap between single player and co-op mode further encourage you to play with your friends. A few small issues occurred during my time with the game. The prompt to revive your partner was always just off to the side of their body, which became frustrating when trying to revive them and escape enemies simultaneously. Getting too close to bobcats while repelling them with fire would sometimes push me in front of them, causing them to attack me. Checkpoints were also temperamental and didn't always save my progress, forcing me back to an earlier part of the level on death. Now, the levels are small and short, meaning the backtracking didn't waste significant time, but the lack of consistency was quite frustrating. All of these problems were irritating, but they didn't ruin my overall enjoyment of the experience. The 2D pixel art uses the bright colours of the elements to bring the environments and characters to life. Despite enemy screens being comically loud, the sound effects suit the tone of the world. As someone who typically avoids stealth in games, I really enjoyed experimenting with the variety of skills on offer in Wildfire and felt like the game catered for my playstyle while still maintaining its identity as a stealth game. Wildfire is out May 26 on PC.